him right now.
Hallelujah.
God, in Jesus' name. in town. Hey, thank you! Mama. Thank you, Jesus. Y'all grab your Bibles. We're going to the Word of God right now. Thank you, Jesus. Acts, the 12th chapter. Acts, the 12th chapter. Yeah. God bless you, Murphy. God bless you, sir. Thank you. Thank you. Hallelujah. Acts, the 12th chapter. Amen. The house has already been addressed. Amen. I'm ready to move into the Word of God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. 12th chapter of Acts, amen. Verse 1 through 3. Hallelujah. 1 through 5, I'm sorry. 1 through 5. Hallelujah. Now about the time Herod the king stretched forth his hands to vex certain of the church. And he killed James, the brother of John, with the sword. And because he saw it pleased the Jews, he proceeded further to take Peter also. Then were there days of unleavened bread. And when he apprehended him, he put him in prison and delivered him to the four quadrants of soldiers to keep him, intending after Easter to bring him forth to the people. Peter therefore was kept in prison, but prayer, there it go again, but prayer was made without ceasing for the church unto God for him. 12th verse. And when he had considered the thing, he came to the house of Mary, the mother of John, whose surname was Mark, where many were gathered together praying. There it goes again. And as Peter knocked at the door of the gate, the damsel came and hearkened, named Rhoda. And when she knew Peter's voice, she opened not the gate for gladness, but ran in and told how Peter stood before the gate. And God's word is blessed. Amen. For a few minutes, amen, I want to speak into your hearings today. But there's a group of people that I want to talk to today that God wants to move you past the pain. I'm talking to somebody today. I said, God wants to move you past the pain. You know what your pain is this morning. You don't have to tell the congregation, but you know what your pain is that you've been dealing with for however long you've been dealing with. I come to tell you, God wants to speak to you on today. For there is a fresh start that awaits. I'm speaking prophetic to somebody there. I say there is a fresh start for somebody today that God wants to enter into. You've been dealing with this thing too long. It's been bothering you mentally too long. Depression has weighed you down too long. There is a fresh, somebody say fresh, start. You're not a victim, you're a victor. Did y'all hear what I said? You are not a victim, but you are a victor. If you believe that, come on, clap your hands and give God some praise. I wish you could have been here Thursday, because this thing is just continuing over and over and over again. Amen. More prayer, more power, y'all. Y'all been hearing it uttered, amen, ever since the beginning, amen, of the year. More prayer, more power. Ah, there's a freshness in the air on today. But look at somebody and tell them, whatever you do, Don't stop.
Don't stop praying.
It is the afflictions of our trials. It is the affliction of our infirmities, amen, of the furnace that allows us, you and I, to grow and to gain some strength so that we can operate, amen, on the level that God really wants us to operate. Whether it's in the choir, whether it's in the pulpit, amen, on the missionaries, the mothers, with the deacons, with the body of Christ at large, there is a level that God wants all of us to operate in. You can't get there playing patty cake with the devil. I got to talk to you today. What are you saying, brother? God would not allow, amen, any of us to grow, amen, to go through anything, amen, that will destroy us. Help me today, Holy Ghost. When the Lord allows that thing to come, that thing that come will strengthen you. It has a purpose. Do you not know, amen, that your pain has a way of deciding your goal? Amen, amen. If you had the chance, amen, to win, amen, to interview some of those people, amen, whether they be in the church or out of the church, that has attained different things in their life, they will tell you they have to go through some things. Bill Gates will let you know that he had to go through some things. The owners of Kraft and Heinz, amen, will let you know they had to go through some things. But they stayed diligently and giving God that that belonged to God. I'm trying to help somebody in the house on today. My pain can decide my goal as to whether or not I'm going to come out victorious, or am I going to just lay over and not be victorious. Because I learned that pain will drive you to a corner, or pain will drive you to a prayer room. Pain has a way of making you pray even when you don't feel like praying. Are there any prayer warriors in the house? Pain has a way of making you lay your hand on yourself and not waiting for anybody. I know what James, amen, 5:14 said, if any among you, amen, be sick, let him call for the elders of the church, amen, and let them anoint your head with oil and let them pray, amen. But every now and then, pastor may be on vacation. Every now and then, the missionary may be doing that thing. Every now and then, I know he's a prayer warrior, but you may call him, and his line may be busy. That's when God needs to lift up something in you. And you got to grab that ball of oil that has been given unto you. And every now and then you got to slap yourself on the head and say, pain be gone. Body be healed. Back come under subjection. Arthritis, get out of these knees. Yeah, yeah. Have mercy, Lord. How many of you have ever had a pain to birth a change? Pain, amen, determines my praise. I don't feel like praising him, but I will. I say I got a pain right now, but I will. Yeah. There's some pain mentally that I'm dealing with, but I will. Bless the Lord at all times. And his praises. I say, and his praises shall continually be in my mouth. Somebody ought to tell the Lord thank you. So the church went through a period, a very defining period, amen, in the book of Acts. What is happening to the church? The the church of Acts is having to suffer persecution. They are the target of a devilish attack. It is, amen, no secret that we all are going through some devilish attacks. How many of us can shame the devil and tell the truth? We're going through even right now. But I know God is going to bring me out all right. I know that God is going to bring me out as a victorious person. Good God Almighty. Yeah, yeah. One thing we got to keep in mind, saints. Whenever you call on the name of God, whenever you call on the power of the Holy Ghost, we know that God is going to make a way of escape. We know from our situation. I just want to know, how many do you have to go through? Amen. What do I have to go through in order to obtain what I need from God? You see, it's not an issue of whether or not I'm going to come out. I'm going to come out victoriously. I just need to know what I got to go through. Good God Almighty. So the church had to go through some very difficult times. And I'm on my way home. Amen. But what the church did do, the Bible said the church began to pray. I said the church began to pray. In other words, when we come in as one body, when we get together as a corporate body, when the time of prayer has been called, I know you can pray on your own. And God wants you to pray on your own. I want you to pray on your own. But something happens when the corporate body comes together and begins to pray. I want to drop something in this place on today. For what you have been praying for what you have been going through, for what you have been dealing with. The Bible says in Isaiah 62:1, for Zion's sake, good God Almighty, I will not keep silent, saith the Lord. And the Lord is speaking, good God Almighty, never again shall you be called God's forsaken land and the land that God has forgotten. But you shall receive double for your trouble. You shall receive a double portion. And not only that, you shall be declared the land of God, God's delight. You are the bride, and God clings to you. He claims you as his bride. So the church was suffering persecution. And what is going on in the book of Acts? Well, the enemy is out to destroy Peter, just like he's out to destroy you, just like he's out to destroy me. You can tell that Peter was somebody in the church. Peter was somebody that knew the Lord, because the Bible says the church went down to Mary, where Rhoda was, for prayer. And when all got together, they heard a knock at the door. Good God Almighty. Oh, good God Almighty. With one accord. And you see, the power of the Holy Spirit is unlike never before. They were all down at Mary's house. Good God Almighty. Praying. Down on their knees. Calling on the Lord. Well, as they prayed, God got busy, just like he's got busy in your life when trouble rises, just like he got busy in my life when trouble came about. Yeah, yeah, just like he got busy when the doctors denied Joe's case. Yeah, yeah, yeah. But tell somebody, I don't believe. Come on, tell somebody, I don't believe that he brought me this far to lead me. Weeping man, endure for a should lean over and tell somebody joy is coming. Come on, tell somebody joy is coming. Come on, tell somebody joy is on the way. Yo-Yo, you ought to get up out of your seat and go touch about three people and tell them your joy is coming. I know if had not been for somebody praying for me, I can't do this by myself. This is too big. But when the power of prayer is relevant, where you are, where you worship, where you live, thank God I got a praying home. Amen. Thank God I had a praying mother and a praying father that taught me how to pray. Even if you didn't have one, amen, there is no excuse. Because if you want it, you can have it. God can give you anything that your heart desires if you seek him first. Come on, stand all over the building. I pray for you. You pray for me. And watch God change me. Come on, all over the building. Come on. As a matter of fact, let's start making our way to this altar right now. Just one big gathering. Come on, all over the building. You need something from God. I'm already here. Because Lord knows I need something from God. Come on, tell him.
I pray for you.
Let's let the Lord fix it this morning.
You pray for me.
Come on in closer. Y'all come on in just a little closer. Come on, let the Lord do it. Come on in. Come on up. Come on up. Hallelujah.
Oh, oh, oh.
Y'all come on in just a little bit more.
And watch God change me.
Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, thank you. Thank you, Lord. Says it, and he says it over and over again. If my people, y'all hear what I'm saying? If my people, which are called by my name, if you would humble yourselves and pray. But you know what? He didn't stop right there. You got to do something now. You got to turn from your wicked ways. Then you're going to receive the glory of God. You're going to see the glory and the healing. The glory is going to come in your house, and your children are going to be saved. Your grandchildren are going to be healed. I got a grandchild that I got on the altar even today. I've been praying and asking God to do something miraculous in his life. Not him, but all the others, amen, but he has a condition that only God can do. You're not the only one, but Pastor got some things on this altar this morning.
Where love flows because God is in control. A church where God is really real. Hi, my name is Dennis Rogers, pastor here at the Greater New Bible Word Church of God in Christ. I would like to welcome you to our services. Service times are Sunday morning prayer and Sunday school, 9 a.m. Sunday morning worship, 11 a.m. Sunday evening Pentecostal service, 7 p.m. Midweek service, Thursday.